Hi everyone, happy spring break. Welcome back to Eagles Insider. We know our teachers work hard and often put other people first. That's why we want to get some advice on how to relax during spring break.
How would you advise other teachers to spend their spring break?
I would advise teachers to lock up their Chromebooks or computers, put those to the side and forget about them, and go away on vacation somewhere tropical and sandy.
I think they should have fun and relax.
Grade and work the whole time.
I believe I would advise other staff members to spend their spring break eating a lot of great food and listening to a lot of great music. And maybe play some golf if you get a chance.
Look over your lesson plans and get rid of everything.
To sleep, because that's all downhill from there.
I would advise teachers to take it easy, rest, enjoy the silence, and then hit the beach.
In these trying and difficult times, we teachers need a good, restful spring break. So it's my opinion that all students should pull together their money and send us on an all-expenses-paid vacation to Hawaii, where we can relax and really recharge our batteries and come back to you students refreshed and ready to go.
Now let's take a look at how students are planning to spend their spring break.
There are so many things you can do over spring break that don't involve going away. You could take a hike with your friends, or you can go on a bike ride. You might even want to try to pick up a new hobby, like painting or baking. You can work on projects that you've started but never finish. You can take time to focus on your mental health, or you could start a healthy workout routine and start eating healthier. Today we interviewed students and teachers to see what their plans are for spring break.
What are your plans for spring break?
I don't know. I kind of want to go to California, just cause.
What are your plans for spring break?
I'm on a rider. What are your plans for spring break?
Baseball.
Baseball. Baseball.
What are your guys' plans for spring break?
Baseball.
Basketball.
Did you know it's National Pet Month? Today we're looking at some of the best pets.
These are the top 5 cutest exotic animals that you can have as pets. The fennec fox, axolotl, degu, cockroach, and sugar gliders. These animals are not common pets but are easy to own and are good companions. Would you have any of these animals as pets?
What is your dream pet?
A monkey.
Do you have any animals?
Yes.
What's their names?
Baxter and Lulu.
What is your dream pet?
A lion.
Do you have any pets?
Yes, I do. I have 2 snakes.
What's their names?
Milo and Stitch.
What is your favorite animal?
A dog.
Do you have any pets?
A dog.
What's its name?
Captain.
What is your favorite animal?
A wolf.
Do you have any animals, and if so, what's their name?
I have a guinea pig.
Favorite animal?
Definitely a dog.
Do you have any pets? If so, what are their names?
I do. I do have a dog, and her name is Ellie.
What is your favorite animal?
Probably a lion.
Do you have any pets, and what are their names?
I have a dog named Buddy, a cat named Spaz, and another cat named Dolly.
April is Stress Awareness Month, and the upcoming break is the perfect time to relieve your stress.
April has come around once again, and it's time to acknowledge the stress and other aspects of it. Stress can also be defined as emotional, physical, or mental strain. It is always good to have a break from something once in a while. Almost always, overworking yourself may cause problems in the end. There are some basic steps you could take to reduce the amount of stress you have. One example is to sleep properly. This may seem minor, but it brings a lot of benefits other than reducing stress. Running your entire day off a minimal amount of sleep can be harmful. It also alters your mood. Even then, you could also try to practice yoga. That helps too. Always remember to take a break and de-stress.
Tomorrow is National Titanic Remembrance Day. Here's more of the unsinkable ship that sank.
The Titanic sank in the Atlantic Ocean in the early morning of April 15, 1912. It hit an iceberg on Sunday, April 14, while making the trip from England to New York City, and sank 2.5 hours later. The sinking of the Titanic killed about 1,500 people out of 2,240 passengers. We remember this tragic event because the Titanic was so impactful on people, it was even made into a The Titanic movie portrays the true emotions and inhumanity that went on as the ship sank. Even though the ship was said to be unsinkable, it clearly wasn't.
April is National Distracted Driving Awareness Month. Here's more on the importance of driving responsibly.
It's National Distracted Drivers Awareness Month. This is when people have to be aware of the decisions they make while on the road. Some distractions include talking or texting on a phone, eating and daydreaming. 1 out of 4 car crashes in the U.S. happen because of texting and driving. If you have to text, pull over to the side at a safe location. Otherwise, you will face high fines, jail time, and license suspension. So make sure you are driving responsibly.
Now that baseball is back, we would like to share our picks for the top MLB teams.
Here are the top MLB teams right now in the AL. Number 1, the Blue Jays. The Blue Jays have a very good young core with Bo Bichette and Vladimir Guerrero Jr. They also acquired Matt Chapman, one of the best third basemen in baseball for the past 6 years. Number 2, the Chicago White Sox. The Chicago White Sox are another team with a very solid young core. Even with the majority of their star players out for a lot of the season last year, they still finished first in the AL Central. Number 3, the Rays. The Rays will be another good team, even though they don't have any standout players. They've been a solid team every year for the past 6 years. Number 4, the Angels. The Angels, even though the Angels aren't very good, even with a good roster, I think their pitching got better in the offseason. And with a healthy Mike Trout and a healthy Shohei Ohtani, they'll be a very good team this year. Number 5, the New York Yankees are very good on paper. They have a bunch of all-stars, but they have come up short in the past few years to the Red Sox, Astros, and the Rays in the playoffs. If their bullpen can hold up in the postseason, they'll be in the World Series and be World Series contenders.
We've all been loving the soft pretzel sales after school. Did you know April's National Soft Pretzel Month?
This month is National Soft Pretzel Month. Here's a quick segment on how to make your own homemade soft pretzels. First, mix together water, salt, and sugar in a bowl. Then, add yeast and let the mixture sit for 5 minutes. Then add 2 tablespoons of oil and mix until dough is formed. Cover dough with plastic wrap and leave in warmth for 1 hour. Next, twist dough into a pretzel shape and boil it in a large pot of water and baking soda for 30 seconds per side. Transfer boiled pretzels onto a baking sheet and bake for 10 to 15 minutes at 450 degrees. Did you know boiling the pretzels in water beforehand is what makes soft pretzels have their soft inside with a pretzel shell on the outside?
Today is National Dolphin Day. Here's some more on dolphins.
National Dolphin Day is on April 14th. It celebrates to raise awareness for dolphins becoming extinct slowly. Dolphins are water mammals that belong to the same family as whales and porpoises. There have been many representations of dolphins in popular books and films showing how extremely social and friendly they are. Most of these popular representations are very accurate. Dolphins can be found in many parts of the world, although they prefer shallow waters. 3 interesting facts about dolphins are they are carnivores. There are also 49 species of dolphins, and dolphins can swim up to 37 miles per hour. That's all for today's show. Thank you for watching and have a great spring break.